Welcome to the glass plate. In this exercise, we're going to look at a continuous stirred tank reactor of a certain volume in which initially there's a concentration of salt in water. So it's a salt water tank. A flow of clean water with concentration zero and a flow rate of phi sub v is flowing in. And as the tank is completely full, it's also flowing out. To do some numerical examples, we're going to set this at 100 liters, the initial concentration of salt, 30 kilogram per cube, and the inflow, 5 liters per second. And I want to analyze the system and understand what's going on. Clean water is flowing in, salt water is flowing out. Three questions we're going to address. First, what happens in the long run if you let T go to infinity? Second, how does the mass balance for salt read? Third, what happens at T equals 20 seconds? What is then the salt concentration? Let's start with the first part and do it qualitatively. What happens if you wait long enough? Well, this is a continuous stirred tank reactor, so during its operation it has a uniform concentration C in the tank, but it may change in time. And as that is uniform, whatever you take out has that same concentration in the outflow, but that may also, of course, vary in time. Now if I overlook this, we put in constantly clean water and we take out some salty water. If you do that long enough, you start diluting further and further this system. Sooner or later, and actually later, there will be no salt left. So I can answer this one qualitatively and we will use that to analyze our result. In the long run, C should go to zero. Constantly salt goes out, and at some point there is no salt left. To find out how that works, we need to do 2 and 3. And for that, we start with the basics. So we need to set up a balance, a mass balance in this case, and we're going to do that step by step. We start with the general formula for balance equations. And the first question we need to ask ourselves, what kind of balance? Well, that's given here. It's a mass balance over the salt. So here, transport of salt should be filled in. Second that we need is over what control volume. If you don't have a control volume, you cannot set up a balance because you don't know what is in and out and you don't know how much is sitting there. Our control volume will be V, the entire tank. Now I can fill this in. First question, once we have solved these, is this steady or unsteady? Well, we already discussed that in the long run, no salt will be left. We started with salt, so this must be unsteady. Thus the dTT term is non-zero, and it actually reads as volume times concentration, because this is the mass of salt. It's a mass balance for the salt. Then we need to concentrate on the right-hand side. What is flowing in? Well, there is water flowing in, but it carries no salt, a zero concentration if you want. So the inflow is written in this format, it's a zero. The outflow has a similar format. There is flow of water out and that carries with it a concentration C that we don't know yet. But this is at any moment what goes out. And then the production term, it is zero. There is nothing producing salt here. Okay. I have my mass balance. Now I need to try and solve that and back out what happens over time. When I do that, let's go back to the black. The volume that I choose, just the volume of the tank, is a constant, so that can be taken out. CdT is the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, all that is left is minus V sub V times the concentration. This can be solved by separation of variables. So everything with the unknown concentration is on this side, everything else goes to the other side. I can integrate these both. This gives me the logarithm of C, and this gives me a linear relation in T, and I should not forget to add an integration constant. That integration constant is always found from boundary conditions, and I have one at T equals 0. The concentration C was a known C0, 30 kilogram per cube. If I fill that in, I get that C over C naught is exponent, well, let me write it slightly different. I'm going to back out explicitly C. The concentration is function of T equals C naught exponent minus 5V over V times T. Okay, does this make any sense? Can we, in retrospect, now that we think we have a solution, inspect this solution and see whether this is potentially true? Yes, we can. There are a few simple things that I want you to do always. First, check the dimensions in your equation. On this side, kilogram per cube. So this should be kilogram per cube. C naught is kilogram per cube. Then this should be dimensionless. And it is. Exponents, signs, are by themselves dimensionless. So this part is okay. But it is an exponent of something, and that should be dimensionless. You cannot take the exponents of 7 seconds. Okay, let me inspect the dimensions here. Cubic meter per second for the flow rate divided by cubic meter, that leaves 1 over seconds multiplied by time, dimensionless. So that's correct. Dimensionally okay, which is a big help. Then I can see, do I still capture in my solution the initial condition? If I fill in T equals 0, then my formula should spit back that the concentration is C naught. Let's see. If T equals 0, then the exponent is taken as exponent of 0, that is 1. 1 times C naught is indeed C naught. So my initial condition is captured in this formula. I get that back. Then from 1, I do know that if you wait long enough, the concentration should go to 0. That's reflected in the exponent. The higher T, the bigger this number, the more negative the exponent is, and thus the exponent of a big negative number is small and goes to 0. So I capture that one. I trust that we have a good solution. Then I can compute C. That's too low. Let me do that here. C at T equals 20 seconds equals C naught times the exponent of minus, what did we have, 5 liters per second over 100 liter of the tank times 20. Oh, this is minus 1 C naught times e to the power minus 1 is, let me take a quick peek, 11 kilogram per cube. It's just an illustration. Once you have this general formula, obviously you can find at any time what the concentration of salt in the tank is.